And for them that have not made love, get fucked.
Behind the walls of this Accrington adobe lives Britain's greatest comedy mastermind. In this shocking series of interviews, we meet the man behind the mask. The man who some say was the star of the Roswell Field footage. The man whose charity show for the Liverpool police was condemned by Derek Hatton and the subject of TV's World in Action. The man condemned in Parliament by John Major, yet greeted and congratulated by the Queen of England. A man to middle-of-the-road comedy what W.C. Fields and Harold Wilson were to hang gliding. Only you can decide in this shocking compilation of the worst of Bernard Manning, On the Job, in performance and in widescreen interview confessions. Together, we fish for the facts. Bernard Manning, one of the most controversial comedians in the United Kingdom. Most recently on the front pages of newspapers, a scandalous act for the British police. A controversial man. Aren't you ashamed of yourself?
Absolutely not.
What do you think of Pakistanis?
Well, I couldn't eat a whole one. Yeah, I've got a Pakistani lives next door to me. And he says to me the other day, I'm a better man than you. I say, I never said you fucking wasn't. What makes you think you're a better man than me? He says, I've not got a fucking Paki living next door to me. So, you know, they're jokes. You must never take them serious. The Pakistani that lives next door to me, he's a doctor, and he's a very clever man, and we're good friends. He wouldn't take offence at that. He'd laugh his bollocks.
Mr. Irish always used to knock about with his Paki, and the Paki got knocked down, killed, stone dead. The copper said, what was his name? He said, we never knew his name, sir. Just used to booze them, you know. He said, where did he live? He says, we knew fuck all about the man, he said. The only thing we knew about him, he had two arseholes. He said, how do you mean? He said, every pub we went in, he used to say, here's that Paki with them two arseholes. What about the Irish fellow went to a Ku Klux Klan fancy dress ball as Al Jolson? Them Irish are unbelievable, aren't they?
Fella going back to Ireland, an Irishman going back to Ireland, that's a fucking change, isn't it? Got in this taxi at Liverpool, and the taxi driver says, it's a long journey to the airport. He said, we'll have a few riddles. He looked in the mirror, he said, brothers and sisters, have I none, but that man's father is my father's son. Who is it? The Irish fella said, I don't know. He said, it's me, isn't it? Fuck me, he says, you're right. He got back to Ireland, he says to his father, I'll give you a bit of a riddle, he said. Looked in the mirror, he said, brothers and sisters, have I none, but that man's father is my father's son. Who is it? His father said, how the fuck do I know? He said, you ignorant cunt. He's a taxi driver in Liverpool.
What about the Irish Working Men's Club went on a mystery tour and they had a suite to guess where they was going? And a fucking driver won 68 quid. Irish family watching television, the old fella said, Bridget! 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 Close your legs. The K-I-D-S can see your cunt. Irish fella, on the top of this blazing building. The fireman shouts, jump in the blanket, Paddy, jump in the blanket. Not fucking likely, he said. You English, you hate the fucking sight of us, he says. I'm jumping in no blanket. I'll jump, you pull the blanket away, he said. Put the blanket on the floor, then I'll fucking jump, he said. It's a pity they can't solve the problems in Ireland, you know, because they're funny nation, no doubt about that. I don't know what they fucking fight about, they're all white. What are they scrapping about? What they want is a million packies rubbing around in the middle of Belfast, you know, they got fucking problems, then all right. We've got the fucking lot here. Azerbaijanis are coming now. What the fuck do they sell? I never heard of such fucking people. Two Irish fellas walking to the Vatican. One said, you see that fella over there with the crooked stick and the mitre cap? I think that's the Pope. He said, I don't think it is. He says, I'm sure it is. So I'll go and ask him. He went up, he says, are you the Pope? He says, fuck up. He went back, he said, what did he say? He said, he wouldn't commit himself.
This fellow went for a job on a building site. He said, what's your name? He says, Paddy Mulligan. He says, how do you spell it? He says, stick the job up your arse. Fucking unbelievable. There's two Jews walking through Glasgow and a big gang of these skinheads come walking towards him. He said, look at these bastards here, Morris. We're going to get mugged here. He said, I think we are. I said, I'm fucking sure we are. Anyways, here's that 600 quid here, owe you. Two Jews talking, one said, what would you do if you won the pool time? If I won £1 million, I'd give you half, you're my best friend. He said, what about if you had two houses? If I had two houses, I'd give you a house, you're my friend. He said, what about if you had two cars? If I had two cars, I'd give you a car. He said, what about if you had two chickens? He says, now, fuck off, you know I've got two chickens. The best Jewish gag ever. Because with Jewish humour, you know, you get the punchline right at the very last second. This one's a fucking masterpiece. Little Jewish fella in the synagogue praying, Lord, he says, help me, please. You're a Jew, I'm a Jew, help me. I don't know which way to fucking turn, he says. I'm up to my neck in debt, he said, I owe every bastard. Please, Lord, let me win the sweepstake. I've got to win that sweepstake, Lord. Everybody gets paid if I win the sweepstake. A week went past, fuck all. He's there again next Saturday morning. Lord, he says, are you fucking listening to me? Please, I've got to win the sweepstake, Lord. Let me win the sweepstake, please. Another week went past. Not a fucking light. He's there again next Saturday morning. He's on his knees now. Get a Jew on his knees, you can block fucking sawdust. Lord, he says, help me, please, you lousy bastard. Let me win the fucking sweepstake. Fuck's sake, he said. Come here three times now, he says. I've got to win that fucking sweepstake, he says. Please. And the clouds parted. And a voice said, Imy, meet me halfway. Buy a fucking ticket. Two Jews about to be shot by the Gestapo, Amy and Imy. Stood there. It's any last request before you're shot? He said, can we stand behind the wall? He said, you better not stand behind the wall. Stand still. The Navy stepped forward. He said, you dirty German bastard. Fuck you and Adolf Hitler. Imy says, don't cause trouble. The Germans are bashing, no, they don't know, you've got to film Holocaust, release it in Germany, you've got the good old days. English fella lived next door to this packy, had a goose, he laid egg in his garden, he went round. He said, I've come for me goose egg. He said, me goose, he's laid egg. He says, oh, no. No, the egg belongs to me, he said. The egg is on my land, the egg belongs to me. That is Indian law. He says, give us that fucking egg. He said, I'm telling you, the egg is on my land, the egg belongs to me. That is Indian law. He said, well, never mind Indian law, we'll have English law just for a fucking change. I kick you in the bollocks, you kick me in the bollocks, the one that gives up first owns the egg. As long as that's the law, he said. Oh, and he gave me a right kick in the bollocks. He said, oh, fucking hell, he said. Oh, that fucking smart start, he said. But it's my turn now. He says, keep the fucking egg. This packy went to this bank. He said, I want to cash a check, please. He said, oh, quite all right, sir. He said, sign the back. No, he said, I don't want to sign the back. I want to sign the front like the white men do. He said, sign the fucking back. He said, I want to sign the front like the white men do. He said, well, you better sign the back. I'll go in the bank across the road, he said. Stormed out, went in this bank across the road, he said, I want to cut a check, please. He
says, turn it back. He said, I want to sign the front like the white men do. I said, don't fuck me about, pal. Sign the fucking back. He said, I want to sign the front like the white men do. Pull him over the fucking car. He said, sign the fucking back. Get it fucking signed. He signed the back. He gave him the money. Went to the bank next day. The first bank he went to, he says, I got that cash for that check. He said, you signed the back. He said, I did. He said, I told you you'd have to. He said, yes, but you didn't explain like the gentleman across the room. This packet went up to heaven there, St. Peter come to the door. He said, yes, what do you want? He says, Randy Sims from Rochdale. And St. Peter shouted in there, anybody order a fucking taxi? This Indian went up to heaven. He said, I'd like to come in, St. Peter. Said, well, it's only for Christians, this place, my old son. He said, well, I give £2,000 to the Christian Aid Society last week. Hang on a bit. He said, I'll go see the boss. He come back, he said, here's your £2,000 now, fuck off. This Negro went to, in Birmingham, Alabama, he says, to vote, like, you know, and this big state trooper said, said, what do you want? He says, I've come to vote. He said, there's no Negroes voting today. He said, I can read and I can write, so I've come to vote. He says, can you write? He said, I can. He said, get a piece of greaseproof paper and a fucking biro pen. Put your name and address on there, he said. He said, I could write when I left home this morning, he said. He said, I'm still voting because I can fucking read, he said. He says, can you read? He said, read that. Fucking Jewish Chronicle. He said, I don't know what the small print says, but the headlines are, there's no Negroes voting today.
South Africa's the place, even the liquorice sauce horse is separate bags over there, you know. They won't be fucked about, them South Africans. There's two South Africans walking through the jungle. There's a lion there licking all the lion's arse. He said, that's a bit unusual. He said, no, he's just a nigger. He's trying to get the fucking taste out of his mouth. Oh, they bastards, they're not like us, tolerant. What about the kind white South Africa went up to this nigger with two tyres burning round his neck? He says, for fuck's sake, take one off, he said. Never mix cross flies with radio.
I like to go to Liverpool once a year to visit my fucking hubcaps. What a piss all of a fucking place that is. There's that many houses boarded up in Liverpool, the fucking window cleaner's got a sander. I went to see City play just after last Christmas. We drew one apiece, little scouser come up, at Anfield. She said, can I mind your car, mister? I says, no, there's a fucking Rottweiler in the back of there. Oh, he said, he can put fire out, can he?
Oh. A scouser went for a job in a building site. The foreman said, what would you want to paint that 80-foot chimney? He said, 80-foot fucking brush. Scouser got for a prostitute. She said, would you like a blowjob? He said, will it affect me dough money?
Let me move now to questions about sex. What is, you know, in your life experience, Why is sex so funny?
Because it's a little bit of a mystery to most young fellas. I mean, most of them's never seen a cunt head on. unless they watch the Michael Barrymore show.
The British audiences seem to be obsessed with bottoms. Why?
Well, I could go to ask myself, I don't know about you. There's nothing worse than a big rhino ass to put you off a fuck in the first place, isn't it? And one that's fucking saggy. So you want a nice, rounded ass. And you can think to yourself, I'd love to get into that. Backwards, forwards, it's like the old joke. A fellow went to Bangkok, he said, it's fucking marvellous, he said. the birds over there do anything for you, he said. Fucking marvellous, he said. Caught for one last night, he said, the fucking lot, the Monty. He said, did you back Scuckler? He said, no, didn't have a fucking bet all week. You know about the two fellas in the army and miles away from anywhere. One fella said, what do you do for a fuck out here? He said, oh, sheep, there's only sheep, he said. They feed them with hay every morning about 7 o'clock, he said. You've got to get up there early. Got up at 6:30 next morning. They're all running like fuck to Aldous Field. He says, what are they all running for? He said, well, you don't get an ugly one, do you? You know, the Australians, they found a new use for sheep. Meat and wool. Give you that.
Are you all set for the jumping season, then?
I'll do the joke, son. I'll do the joke. Thank you. All the best.
Cross-country runner run right in this quicksand. Sinking slowly. He's up to there. The runner going past, he said, get us out, will you, pal? He said, only if you suck me dick.
Fuck off, he says.
The other runner going past, he's up to here now. He said, get us out, will you, pal? He said, only if you suck me dick, pal. Not bleeding likely, he said. He's up to here now. The fella going past, he said, for Jesus' sake, get me out of here, please. I'll suck your dick for you. He said, you dirty bastard, get out of here. I'm bisexual, me, you know, if I can't get it, a fucking bite. One thing I couldn't be fucking queer, I'll tell you. I couldn't stand fellas refusing me as well as women. Fella 6'8", used to go out dancing, he says to his pals, I'm not coming no more. He said, I'm fucking sick of this. He said, I never get a partner. You're all waltzing past me. He said, I'm sat on my arse here. He said, it's not fucking good to me, this, he said. He said, I'm not coming no more. 3 weeks later, the phone rang. Get down here quick, there's a bird in here, 6'6". A dolly. Shoots down there, he's dancing with it all night. She's blowing in his ear. She said, you want to fuck? He said, well, I'm a bit embarrassed. He said, I've got a dick as big as a 5-year-old. She said, like that? He said, no, like that. He said, and I walked into a bank. He said, I'd like to put a few quid in. She said, oh, it's not that type of a bank. She said, it's a sperm bank, this. He said, how do you mean? She said, well, people that can't have children, we pass the sperm on to them. She said, well, I won't waste a journey. I'll leave you drop while I'm here. She said, well, take this jarl in that room, throw it over your thumb, come back and you've done. Come back 2 hours later, sweating cops. She said, what's up? He said, what's up? I've had it in my right hand, my left hand, in the door jam, under the hot water tap. I still can't get the bloody lid off this jarl. Well, when I went to a sperm bank, there's 60 in the queue. He thought, geez, I must be in the wrong queue here. Tapped this woman on the shoulder, said, is this a queue for the sperm bank? This doctor says to this fella now, your wife's either got Alzheimer's disease or AIDS. He said, we give the thorough examination. He said, we can't fathom it out. He said, well, what do we do then? He said, well, on your way home in the car, he said, drop her off about 4 miles from your house. If she comes home, don't fuck her. This surgeon went up to this fella this ward. He said, Mr. Jones, he says, yes. He said, well, I've got a bit of bad news for you. He said, there's another Mr. Jones in this ward, and he's in for a sex change. And we'll give it you instead of him. He said, you haven't got a prick now, you've got a cunt. Fuck it, hell, he said. Does that mean I'll never see another erection? He says, well, you'll see fucking blinky, but it won't be yours. Some ugly masses about, though, I'll tell you. Quasimodo went on Mastermind, sat down, he said, good evening, everybody, good evening. Never mind all that bollocks. What do you answer questions on? He said, masturbation. You can't answer questions on masturbation. He said, well, I've started now, so I'll finish it. He's retiring, Quasimodo. He's getting 40 years back pay in a lump sum. Fellow went to the doctors and said, I've got a mole on the end of my prick.
He says, drop your kegs. He says, well, I can get them all off, he says, but I'll have to report you to the RSPCA. Posh fella stood at the bar with this working lad. He says, I bought my wife a Mercedes yesterday and a Rolls Royce. The Mercedes to knock about town and shop, and the Rolls to go to Ascot Newmarket Place, you buy that. I said, I bought my wife a pair of slippers and a vibrator. Oh, yes, he said, I. Said, if you don't like the slippers, you can go fuck yourself. So anyway, this fella had a bionic arm put on. He said, how am I going to work with this? He said, well, you just say, a nice cup of tea. He said, a nice cup of tea. And he went. Oh, I said, that's pretty marvellous, that. He said, you tell it to do anything you want. Got it home at night, he's in bed there. I said, give us a wank. And he went, wank, 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 wank. And he pulled his prick off. He said, fuck me. And he went, whoa! Fella wrote up for one of these blow-up dolls. Said, I must have realism. Don't send me a doll if I can't have realism. Sent it this doll, the postman delivered it. Thought, I wonder what's in here. Sees this blow-up doll, he thought, oh, aye, aye. Give it one. Put it back in the box, delivered it. Fortnight later, this fella got a message. He said, we've never heard from you. What about the realism with the doll? He wrote back, realism? I got a fucking dose of it. Fella giving this bird one, she said, you've only got a small organ, haven't you? She said, yes, but it's never played in a cathedral before. So she said, oh, I'm not grumbling, what you've got's very good, she said, but I'm a little bit kinky, she said, would you bite me ears while you're giving me one? I said, oh, where do you want to bite in? She said, just on the lobes there, gentle. So he went. She said, just kiss me bus very quick while you're biting me ears, sorry. She said, rub me arse at the back slow. And put on the cheeks quick, so she said, it slipped out. He says, no fucking wonder, I forgot what I was doing. He said, the woman went to the vicar. She said, vicar, I must tell you, she said, I lost my temper this morning. I called the man a fucking bastard this morning. My God, he said, there's no justification for that. She said, well, he put his hands on my breasts. He said, you mean like this? I've not forgot her, son. I've not forgot her. Right? She says, yes. He said, there's still no justification for that. She said, would he give me one? He said, you mean like this when he gets on the job and he's banging away there? She said, yes, and he's giving me AIDS. He said, the fucking bastard. The fairy godmother said to Cinderella, if you're not in here before 12 o'clock for that ball tonight, your fanny will turn into a pumpkin. Well, she's down to this big handsome bastard here. What's your name? He says, Prince Peter, the pumpkin eater. What time you gonna be in? She's 6:30. I walked up to this woman in this pub, said, I'd like to fill your fanny with draft guineas and suck the lot. She ran up to us and said, you know what he's just said to me? He'd like to fill my fanny with draft guineas and suck the lot. He said, if you think I'm tackling a fella that can suck 28 pints of draft guineas, fuck you. Well, I walked in this brothel, and I've only got a tenner. She said, there's nothing here for a tenner, son, unless you have the penguin. He said, what's that? She said, go room number 7, she'll explain. Dolly bird, absolutely delicious. Come in, she said. He said, well, I've only got a tenner, I've come for the penguin. She said, give us the tenner. She stuck it away. He said, what's all this about a penguin? She said, oh, you'll be very satisfied, don't worry about that, she said. She unzips his flies, drops his catch round his ankle and his underpants. She walked away. The music struck up. She stripped off slowly. Gorgeous, absolutely. He stood there with a right fucking stand on by defying gravity. She walked back, she could only be like that, she went like that. With a song in my heart, I behold your adorable face. And he's just about to shoot, and she walked away. He says, where the fucking hell are you? His doctor said to this fella, now I've got good news and bad news. He said, what's the bad news? He says, you've got AIDS. Fucking hell, he said, what's the good news? He says, you've got Alzheimer's disease, you little fuck all about it.
What about the guy who comes along and he decides he's going to take you on? He's going to take Bernard Manning on, and he's got a couple of really, maybe quite good lines that he's going to throw at you from the crowd. Does that ever happen?
Yes, but he's right away, he's no fucking chance because I've got the microphone. You see, he could be the funniest man in the world, but nobody can fucking hear him. You see, I've got the microphone. You see. And they say to each other, yeah, you big fat bastard. I say, big fat rich bastard. I say, when I die, it'll be in all the newspapers on television. When you die, no fucker will know you've gone. You're just a fucking nobody. You'll be lucky if the Undertaker turns up.
What about drunks? I mean, obviously...
You can't do nothing with a drunk, only make him look more fucking drunk.
Yeah.
I said, well, you can't be pissed on this beer. The only time anybody got pissed in this place was during the fucking water strikes. Look at these poor old age pensioners. I bet you've been sat in all week with your overcoats on trying to save a bit of fuel, haven't you? So you can suck Pernod and Malibu and all that. You cheeky old boss, you've never had it so good. And two old girls in the corner there. Are you all right, girls? I bet you're flattened a bit of grass in your time, you two, haven't you? Hey, bet they see more ceiling than Michelangelo, them two. You'll enjoy yourself tonight, don't worry about that. What's her name in the corner, that little old lady? Alice. She looks in fucking Wonderland, she doesn't. Are you all right, Alice? Now, what about this little trainee corpse on the front here? Is he going to fucking last by the end of the show? How are you? I wish you could fucking hear this. It's funny, believe me. I wish you could hear it. He thinks I'm fucking singing this old fella here. You don't believe it. Was it cold in the ground this morning? Say hello to Roy Orbison and when you get back, tell him not to. You look fucking foolish to meet me, old fella. You're not holding a Christmas tree, have you? Throwing your fucking money away. And don't go out on bonfire night, the kids will fucking sling you. I wrote a couple of songs. One's called You Didn't Want Me When I Wanted You, and now that you want me, fuck you. And they won't publish it, they said the title's too long. So we're just going to call it fucking, leave it at that. Release Christmas week, I think. So I wrote another one. It's all about a fella who's waiting for a train to go to Kew Gardens. You know where they grow all the lovely flowers and plants and trees and everything in Kew Gardens in London? He's waiting for a train to go to there, and while he's waiting for this train, he's singing my song. Now, I should get on top of the pops with this. It's so easy to learn. I want to catch a train, fuck you. I want a train, fuck you. I don't want a train to Timbuktu. All I want is a train.
Fuck you!
You know it already. You didn't fucking know that 2 minutes ago, you see. If I don't get on top of the pot to that, there's no fucking justice. Light the fag up, son. Get any Greek? Have you got any Greek fags? Well, give us one of our own, all right then. I'm not proud. Fucking bastard. Ah, give us a light. I'm not Paul Daniels, you know. This fucking hell's on. The wife, eh? Fucking hell. You got a fucking good sense of humor, you haven't. You foreigners come over here, get all the fucking best girls. Now over here on this table here, ladies and gentlemen, celebrating tonight, there's two young men with us tonight that fought at Goose Green in the Falkland Islands. Thank you very much. Over here on this front table. Celebrating with us tonight. Thank you. Come on there. They're Argentinians. And if you want to clap for shit like that, you're all good. Cheeky bastards coming in here. Who's this fucking midget walking about? Is there a circus in town or what?
I ho! How are you, Sam? You make a good burger, you. Your arse is up your footprint, Sam. Give you a job later on serving the fucking drunks under the table. What about your mate there with fucking desert head there? How are you? Been using that wash and go, haven't you? You washed it and he's fucking gone, all right. If your hair gets any further back, you're combing your fucking arse. How long you been over here, boys? How long you been over here? Pardon?
10 years.
10 years? Well, I suppose you're used to the place now, aren't you? Are you in business at all?
Yeah.
What business are you in?
Markets.
You stand markets? Oh, very nice, that. Lovely. I'm not in a shop yet. That's the next move. That's the next move, isn't it? You've heard about the fellas going round Bradford taking pot shots at Sikhs, and the police have nicknamed him the Terminator. It's nice to see the Grumbleweeds in the club tonight anyway. Give them a nice round of applause. Very, very talented young men. Got a great future. They appeared here many, many years ago for £125, but it was just six of you.
Five.
I think I got fucked that week. There's only five. Hey, I paid for six. Anyway, it was £125 and I don't begrudge it. You can come back again any time you want. Same fucking money, though.
You Japanese never fucking laughed, do you? Hey? But not forgot Pearl Harbor, pal. Don't fucking worry about that. The fucking shithouse trick that was. December the 7th, 1941, you fucking lousy fuck. Look at him sat there. He can't wait to get home and make another Datsun. You look a nice young fella, don't piss on this fucking jack over there. Bastards.
No fucking time for me. There was a plane crashed in Madrid about 6 months ago. 200 Japanese on that plane, broke my fucking heart. Six empty seats there was. Well, you've been very good, lads. We're going to sing Me and My Shadow now, dead easy, this. You know this one? Oh, me and my shadow. I'll prompt you. And fuck you, pal, as well. I'll get you on the way back, don't you fucking worry about that. You make a good burglar, you, your arse is on your footprints out.
Me, my shadow.
Well, I hope you footprint you send.
You should know.
Like a fucking tire going now, that
you
one.
You should know, Bill.
Rolling down the avenue.
Not bad, that. Don't really worry about that.
Me, we want to be together. We want to walk in a garden.
I don't give a fuck about the garden. How about that?
We want to be together.
That's the best fucking advert I've ever seen, that. He's looking at him as though he's fucking mental. And when he looks like that,
strolling down the avenue.
You're not fucking quick, are you?
How bad do you want to know? Not,
here's a million-dollar question. What is funny? What
Everything's
makes a
funny.
Crowd, everybody laugh?
Everything's funny. Psychiatrist gags. Fella walks in and says, can you help me out? He says, "Why? Which way do you come in?" So, you know, little quickies like that. Fat people. Cyril Smith just walked a water bend, fucking Lake Windermere. Fella walked in a pub, he says, 8 brandies, please. You're not the 8 brandies back. He said, I shouldn't be drinking like this with what I've got. She said, what have you got? He says, fuck all.
If you like a smoke, have a smoke. If you like a drink, have a drink. If you like chips, have chips. If you like bread, have bread.
Take no fucking notes of these specialists. They'll have you in bed for 7 o'clock. Drink and drive if you want. There's nothing worse than having a smash if you're fucking stone cold sober. The copper says, all the back end's hanging off. He says, I don't give a fuck. When the police pull you up, you know, they must caution you. Remember that, they've got to caution you. They say to you, you're not obliged to say anything, but anything you do say will be taken down and used in evidence. Your next sentence must be, please don't hit me again, officer. Fella up in court, the judge says, you're charged with battering your wife to death with a hammer. And a voice at the back of the court says, you fucking shithouse. And it all went quiet, you know. He says, you're also charged with battering your daughter to death with a hammer. And a voice at the back of the court says, you lousy bastard. The judge said, well, this can't go on. He says, come here. Now, he said, I can understand you've been a bit upset about this case, but any more outbursts like this, I shall charge you with contempt. And what's the idea? He said, well, I live next door to this bastard for over 20 years, he said. Every time I asked to borrow a hammer, he said he hadn't fucking got one. Fella up in court for stealing an overcoat. The judge says, wasn't you up before me 4 years ago for stealing an overcoat? He says, well, how long do you think a fucking overcoat lasts? Have you anything to say before I pronounce sentence? He said, fuck all. The judge says to his solicitor, what did he just say then? He said, fuck all, Your Honor. He said, I'm sure I saw his lips move. Vicar went to this house, knocked at the door. He says, she said, yes, what do you want? He said, I've come over your little Johnny swearing in class. She said, it's them bastards next door, she said. I'm fucking sick of telling them, she said. Since we moved round here, he said, the shit houses around here, the fucking lot of them. Have a word with his father while you're here. He went in, he said, what the fuck are you on? He said, I've come over your little Johnny swearing in class. He said, I'm sick to fucking death of telling him. It's them kids next door, she will let them play with them. Bastards, a lot of them round here, he said. I'm fucking sick of it, he said. Have a cup of tea while you're here, father. He says, no, I better fuck off now, I've got a massive. Teacher in school says, good morning, children. They all says, good morning, teacher. One says, gears a pencil. Said, you don't speak like that. Said, there's nouns and pronouns and verbs. Sheila has no pencil. Terence has no pencil. I have no pencils. They have no pencils. We have no pencils. He said, who's got all the fucking pencils? She says, can any pupil tell me who said, give us the tools and we'll finish the job? A great English statesman. And this little coon got up, he said, Winston Churchill, 1941. So that's very good indeed. And a voice at the back of the class said, send a black bastard home. And who said that? And Enoch Powell, 1968. And she's writing on the blackboard in a micro mini skirt. She reached up like that. One of the kids went, dropped the chalk, bent down to pick it up. One of the kids went, do-do-do-do-do-do. She said, stand up, the boy with the horn. And all the fucking class got up. On the way to the dentist, he said, what price do you charge? He said, well, we've got three such charges. He said, there's one for £7,000, he says. No blood, no pain, beautiful teeth. He said, we've got one for £2,500. He said, that's just a little bit of blood and nice teeth and just a little bit of pain. He said, what's the cheapest? He says, 40 quid. He said, what's that? He said, oh, loads of fucking blood, pain. Fucking awful teeth. That'll do, he said. I'll send a wife tomorrow morning.
Fellow going abroad, this pilot's going through the passage gate, like, you know, and he said, and he was blind with a guide dog and a stick. He said, what are you? He said, I'm the pilot. He says, pilot? He said, Jesus. He said, how do you know where the instruments are? He said, they're all in Braille. All in bloody in Braille, he said. What about when you get to the end of the runway? How do you know when to pull it up? He said, well, I hear all the passengers say, fucking hell. Unlucky people, steer clear of them. Fellow with no arms and no legs, swimming the channel, got cramp in his ears. But the unluckiest man in this world, he was drowning at sea and this boat picked him up. It was the Titanic. Just got washed and shaved and fucking down again he went. What an unlucky bastard, eh? What about the fella bought a packet of after 8 mints and fucking died at 7:30? Anyway, another of this frivolity. Let's have a gag. Full moon tonight. Can you imagine what it's like in Rampton tonight, a full moon and all them fucking loonies, eh? There's an inspector going round Rampton. There's a fella stood up in bed like that. He said, who are you supposed to be? He said, supposed to be, you cunt. He said, I'm Napoleon. He said, who told you that? He says, God. And the fella in the next bed said, I never told you no such fucking thing. Well, the fella sat up in bed like that. Brum, brum, brum. He said, what are you doing? He said, driving me Maserati. He said, you've got no car. And the fella in the next bed said, now you shouldn't have fucking told him that. I get £7 a week for washing knives. Except the Americans. In America, they call drug shit in America. Think nothing of it. It's a slang word. I didn't know this. I'd never been further than Oldham. Get off the plane. This big coon come up. He said, you want to buy some shit? I said, shit? What kind of shit? He said, best quality shit, man. Best quality. I said, my mate, this bambi bastard wants to sell me some shitty. Fucking unbelievable. Anyway, I bought a bucket full. I wasn't walking about without, I'll tell you that. There was a hippie on the top of the CIS building in Manchester, souped up to the fucking eyeballs. Right on the top, he says, I'm a jumbo jet, I'm a jumbo jet. Fucking dived up. Halfway down, another hippie hijacked him and flew him to Cuba. Unbelievable. Fella walked into a pub, he says, I know your new landlord here. He said, you only moved in a fortnight ago, didn't you? He said, aye. He said, I've made a few changes. He says, we've got opening night tonight, he said. Big night, he said. We've got sandwiches laid on, he said. There's snooker and pool in there, he said. Fitted carpet, he said. We've spent a few bob here. He said, listen, pal, don't get too bleeding busy. He said, I've come in here for 25 years. We've always had snuff on the counter here, he said. You get some snuff on that counter. That's a tip for you. Be back myself in a couple of hours, and good luck with the opening night. All the best. This landlord thought, where the bleeding hell am I going to get snuff on this time of night? Oh, and he got this dog shit off the pavement. Dried it into a fine powder, stuck it in this beautiful silver box. This fella come back, he said, now you're talking, he said. The lads will appreciate this, he said. He said, you've no idea, he said, what this will mean to the lads that come in here, he said. He said, I've come in here for 20 odd years, he said. He said, can you smell dog shit in here? He said, there's no dog shit in this pub. He said, my wife's never stopped cleaning for a fortnight. He said, I can fucking smell it. He said, it's getting worse and all, he said. Whew, he said, he's fucking reeking in here, he said. Fellow walked through the door. He said, can you smell dog shit in here, pal? He went, no. He said, I can fucking smell it anyway. This other fellow went up to the box. He went like that. He said, I'll tell you what, he said, that snuff clears your head, I can smell that dog shit now, he said.
Have you ever had any celebrities try to take you on in your career and sort of said you're offensive or, you know, for whatever?
Yes, I've had, I did 3 Michael Parkinsons a few years ago when the Parkinson show was going. I did 3 of them. And on the first one, they brought Esther Ranson on to nail me because her husband produced the show, I think. Wilcox is his name, Wilcox.
Desmond Wilcox.
He produced the show. And they said, we've got a little upstart comic from the comedians and we'd like you to nail him. So that come unstuck because I made Esther Ranson look like a cunt. I seem to excel on chat shows because they give you a free hand. It's late at night and you can have a bit of a go and say bollocks if you want. What would you get if you crossed George Formby with Eddie Murphy? And you don't know, Nick. You'd get to turn down nice again, you motherfucker. Okay, well, let's get nice normally down here. Liza Fag. Stop me having cancer, I'll have it for you. Fuck Roy Castle.
He's getting some fucking mileage out of that, isn't he? No one will do him till he stops fucking smoking. Hey? Give him 6 months to live, he said, I'll do it in 4. Do you know that 100% of non-smokers fucking die? You know, my ambition is to go live on the Antique Roadshow and say to some old woman, you know that's worth? Fuck all. Not a fucking carrot. Now fuck off with it. That'd liven somebody up, wouldn't it? You better listen to that screeching bastard, Harry Seacombe. Whoever told that man he could fucking sing, I don't know. 40 years you've put with that bloody nonsense. If you ever see him on that highway, I'll knock the cunt down, I'll tell you that. Straight over him I'll go, it's fucking awful. He's not been well, you know, I might get that job. I'll be all right going round them churches, me with them queer vicars. What a lovely church vicar, very nice. And how old is the church? Oh, 800 years. Well, fucking beautiful, isn't it? Very nice. And which hymn would you like, vicar? Oh, him. Now there's a fella, John Lennon, he wanted peace. He's fucking got it. You can't get any quieter than that, can you? He married a Japanese, you don't marry them slant-eyed bastards. To what they did to our troops during the war, unforgivable. Starve them to death, humiliate them, give them dogs and rats and all sorts of shit to eat. Teddy Wait, he had a fucking picnic in there, towards what they were doing. Tied to a radiator, that I loved a fucking radiator. With a fucking edit. All the lovely girls we've got, he's got to marry a fucking Jap. What's her name? Oko Poko or some fucking nonsense. Yoko Ono, that's it. Right, ugly bastard. Face like a blistered piss box. You won't remember piss box, will you, son? Very happy days they were. You didn't know it was full till your thumb got warm at the top. This time last year, it was pissing down with rain. We didn't have a summer like we've just had. It was a bastard this time last year. Terrible. Strikes all over the country. Sid Vicious died. I couldn't fucking sleep when I heard about that. I tossed and turned all night when Sid Vicious died. The dirty, scruffy bastard. They couldn't bury him. The dustbin men were on strike at the time. There was an Irish punk rocker, took a pin out of his nose. His head blew off. Johnny Rotten's just teamed up with Ronnie Barkin. In future, it's going to be good night from me and fuck off from him. That's how the world's gone now. Unbelievable. That's me shaking hands with the Queen backstage London Palladium. Royal Command performer, me, you know. You don't watch any book tonight. He was with her, the Duke of Kent. What a gormless bastard he is. Oh, Mr. Manning laughed my bollocks off tonight. Now, Princess Anne, you want to see her close up? Fucking hell, like shaking on your bedroom. I've a lot of trouble with the royal family, you see. They're getting into the real world now, you see. A fire at Windsor Castle, all that fucking whinging and whining. It was fuck all new in there. It was all on gear. You wouldn't have in the fucking house half of that stuff. They said it was a discarded fag that started the fire. Prince Edward said I had fuck all to do with that. Lord Derby says to Leicester Pickett years ago, if this horse doesn't win today, it's on the fucking milk in the morning. So I'm sick of plowing money to this horse. If he don't win today, it's on the milk. Leicester Pickett, finest jockey ever lived, that boy. Finest jockey ever lived, no doubt about that. Last furlong, out comes a stick. On the shoulders, on the arse. On the shoulders, on the arse. He's knocking fuck out of this horse. It's going backwards. On the shoulders, on the arse, right on the bollocks. The horse pulled up, he said, turn it in. Turn it in with that fucking whip, will you? I've got to get up at 3 o'clock in the morning.
A quick impression, Frank Bruno. Hey, some fucking champion, him. He's got bad eyes now, he didn't find out till he missed the fucking plate with the sauce. Anyway, Mrs. Nelson Mandela's got 6 years, that's fucking happy, aren't they? Hey. Hey. Hope she only does 5, anyway. Hey. She said, she told the judge, I'll never do it. He said, well, do as much as you can. Where's Terry Waite? There's only me asking about that poor bastard, Terry Waite. He'll be running round his cell now trying to catch a beetle or a rat for his supper. I'm going home to steak pudding and chips. You've had a big nosh. Anyway, fuck him. He should stop at home and mind his own fucking business. I bet he won't go again in a hurry, eh? The Archbishop of Canterbury, would you like to go over to... Oh, fuck off, he'll say. Send some other cunt. You wouldn't know, wouldn't you? It's all right sending other people in as long as you're not fucking going. Oh, aye. Do-gooders, they call them. Do-gooders. The fucking world's full of do-gooders. I had a mate like that at school, always busy. What a nosy twat he was. He went to Africa to help the hungry, and they fucking ate him. What kind of tricks are them? I mean, all them Ethiopians needed was Lenny Henry and his fucking big fat wife going over there, showing her what it looks like to eat six fucking meals a day. I bet when they looked at him, they thought it was fucking Gulliver. Oh, dear me.
Animals feature very heavily in your performance. You have a lot of stories about animals. You like animals?
Yes, I do. Yeah, well, I've had a few dogs. I've had a few dogs and I've had a few budgies. And I've got tropical fish, of course. But the nicest story I heard about animals are all round the pond in the jungle. And this mouse said to the hippopotamus, "You ugly cunt, get out of that fucking pool." "Right," he said, "get back in." He said to the giraffe, "You, get twat, get out of that pool." "Right, get back in." He said to the elephant, "Out, let's have a..." "Get back in." The lions lay there, said, "What are you fucking everybody about for? Who have you copped the fucking needle to? What's it all about?" "What's it all about?" he said. "Somebody's nicked my fucking trunks." Now, if I hadn't have said fucking there, you could have put that on Jack and Noah.
This burglar broke into this house. He thought, "I'll have that video, I'll have the television, I'll have that nice little grandfather clock." And a voice said, "I can see you, and Jesus can see you." "No, what the fuck was that?" He turned around, he's just a parrot on a perch. He said, "Was that you?" The parrot says, "Yeah." He says, "You frightened me, you're fucking dead then." He said, "What's your name?" He says, "Archibald." He said, "That's a funny fucking name for a parrot, that, isn't it?" He says, "Not as funny as that fucking Rockwell, little Jesus." There's a dog pissing up against the wall with its four paws like that, and a fella said, "Never seen out like that before." He said, "It's always pissed like that," he said, "ever since the fucking wall fell on it." There's a dog fucking this fella's leg. And he went, "Fuck off." And he was a Doberman. "Oh, right, nasty bastard." And he went, "Ah." He said, "Well, hurry up then." Irish fella went in a shoe shop, bought himself a pair of torture shell shoes, took him 4 hours to walk out of the shop. Little lad says to his dad, "What will we do when my toy dies, dad?" He said, "Well, we get a cardboard box, some flowers, bury it in the garden, get some of your pals round. Chocolates, minerals, ice cream." He says, "Can't we fucking kill it now, dad?" Big gang of fellas running down the road. A fella said, "What's up?" He says, "A lion escaped. Which way did it go?" He said, "You don't think we're fucking chasing it, do you?" You know why seagulls have wings? To beat the fucking gypsies to the tip. You're learning all the time. You're learning all the time. We tell you today, don't eat this, don't eat that. That's bad for you, that's bad for you. We ate any fucking thing in the 30s. Oxtails, sheep's heads, didn't affect us. Fish fingers, ain't no fish had fucking fingers, did you? There's two cows talking in a field. One said, "What do you think about the mad cow disease?" The other one said, "Don't affect me, I'm a fucking duck." Fellow walked into a psychiatrist with a frog growing out of his ear. And the psychiatrist said, how long has it been like that? And the frog said, it started as a boil on my arse. Fellow went to a chemist's shop. He said, have you got a Jorex that big? He said, that don't it fit a mouse? He said, I know, the fucking house is overrun with them. Fellow walked in the pub with a crocodile. The landlord said, get it out. He said, it does tricks. He says, tricks, you barmy bastard. Get that crocodile out of here and now move with the crocodile. He says, you're going to have a thrombosis the way you're going on. He says, calm down. He says, you've not seen the trick yet. What's this? Opens the crocodile's mouth like that. Put his prick in his mouth like that. Got a bit of wood out of his back pocket and bang! Across the head. The crocodile went. Fucking hell, he said, you've got some bottle to out like that. He said, I told it was good. He said, all that fucking screaming and shouting. Anybody in this pub like to try it for 50 quid? This little old woman says, I'll try it. She said, but don't hit me on the fucking head as hard as hit that crocodile.
At the end of the worst of Bernard Manning, for people who still haven't made up their mind as to whether you're a hero or a villain, let's turn the spotlight on and you give them a message.
Well, my message is never take a joke seriously. I'm a father and a grandfather. My stage act is an act. It's not what I take in my own home. I have a wonderful family. I don't think I've ever had a parking ticket in my life. I've never been charged with any offence. I run a good club, the Embassy Club, for 36 years. Never had any problems there. It's been a wonderful life. I've made billions and billions of people laugh. And for them that I've not made laugh, get fucked.